Good morning, everyone. We're continuing here in the words of the Orchis Yosher. Rav Chaim Kanievsky brings down more beautiful ideas about how important it is for a person to work on their midah, their trait of anivus, of humility, and stay away from arrogance. And he writes, V'amru, it's brought down, La'olam ye'odam ona ba'tayru u'maisim toivim. A person should always be humble when it comes to his Torah knowledge, u'maisim toivim, and the good deeds, the mitzvahs that he does, Ubi Yirah Shemayim, and how much fear and awe and reverence of Hashem and heaven that he has. Im Avi V'imoy V'im Rabba V'ishtoy, he should have this humility when he's in the presence of his father, his mother, his Rebbe, his wife, V'im Banov V'im Bnei Beisa Yushchenov, with his children, with his neighbors, V'im Kroivim Rochaikim, with people, his relatives that are close to him and people that are far distant from him, just relationships that he's not so close to, via acquaintances, via filim goy bashuk, even with the non-Jew in the marketplace, a person should always maintain a great level of humility, even though he might be great in his Torah accomplishments, and he might be amazing in the mitzvahs that he does, the chesed that he's involved with, how medaktik, how particular he is with every little detail, and so too, as this Chazal is saying over here, it could be that the person excels in the world of Yirah Shemayim. He has great fear of Hashem, which prevents him from doing sin and from trying to always make the right decisions. Nevertheless, when it comes to dealing with everyone, says Chazal over here, you must maintain a great level of humility in order not to show off anything that you have. Why? Because if a person does that, say Chazal the following, you will then be beloved above to Hashem, v'nechmad lamata, and you will be pleasing in the eyes of everyone that is here, down here in the world. People will appreciate you. They'll see your humility and they'll think to themselves, wow, this is really a great person. So many accomplishments, so many things that he's done, yet he never flaunts himself. He never talks about himself. He never shows off what he has done and what he's accomplished and what he's trying to accomplish. Such a person like that, he's nechmad lamato, or miskambal al brios. Everybody desires to be around him. Everybody accepts him and appreciates him. And he will fulfill his days. He'll live out his days in goodness, b'shem tov, with a good name. People will know about him far and wide. For at the time that a person is humble when it comes to his accomplishments in his learning and his mitzvahs and his good deeds, then his wife, she'll have reverence for him. She'll have awe of her husband. She will so much appreciate and look up to her husband. So to his children, his neighbors, his relatives, they see such a humble person, they will walk around in awe of his nature. Even the non-Jews, when they see the greatness of such a person, they will also be in awe of them. Shenema, like it says, V'ro kolamei ha'aretz, kishem Hashem nikra alecha v'yoru mimeko, like it says in the pasuk, in the verse, then the nations of the world, they will see you, and they see the name of God is called upon you, v'yoru mimeko, and they will revere you. Ad kan l'shana, those are the words of the Tana of the Be'el Yoho, Azut over here, these words of Chazal. It's known that the Chavetz Chaim, the saintly Chavetz Chaim, was such a person with all of his godliness, all of his greatness. He lived every single moment of his life with tremendous humility. And in the town of Radin where he lived, which was not primarily a Jewish town, there was the yeshiva, of course, there was the Jewish shtetl, there was the Jewish area, but there were many non-Jews that lived in that neighborhood. When he would walk down the streets, and especially as he would walk through the marketplace and by the outskirts of town where there were farmlands, the non-Jews, they would beg that the Chavetz Chaim would please walk through their fields. He would walk in front of their store. He would walk along their way. Why? Because they knew that this was a holy man. His humility was far and wide, and people saw his kedusha, his holiness, and they had tremendous reverence for him, and they wanted that the Chavetz Chaim would walk through their fields, walk in front of the stores, that this great man, who was obviously a godly human being, would end up bringing the blessings from God above to the non-Jews that were living there in that town. And that's what we're saying over here. You live a life of humility. You live a life where you don't show off that you have accomplished. That itself is how you will find favor in the eyes of Hashem above, and how you'll find favor in the eyes of the people down here in this world as well. Have a wonderful, wonderful day.